is going to play Chuck's character tonight?
Plot twist, you are.
I can.
Alright, go ahead and grab it. Once everybody's ready, check ready, we'll go. Alright. So, last week we left off. Y'all were going to be... y'all were helping infiltrate in kind of a religious civil war in this town. And then right as the ritual was making headway, this guy showed up.
Just a minor interference.
Yeah, nothing too major. Ajax passed out, aka swooned at the sight of him. So right now, let me get you a map real quick.
So that counts as a rest, though, right?
It does not, unfortunately. It's worth a shot, though. Alright, so this is... Y'all are still out at the docks. The town folks of Slubladoop are going absolutely crazy right now. The Demogorgon is slowly approaching the town banks, and you see some of the guys that ran in the water. There, something's in the water killing them. So what do y'all want to do?
Alright, so where's this behemoth of a scary thing?
He is right below the BLUD, also known as Blood, in the name.
Okay.
Right in that area there, and he's slowly making his way towards y'all. Shashar, he was the one that brought y'all here. He runs up to you and suggests that y'all, you know, get the hell out of Dodge, and that to the east of the town you can probably find some boats to maybe set out and get away from all this. Or you can stand and fight.
I'll ask, Sheldrick will ask Shushar to help us get the wounded.
The wounded of y'all, or the wounded of them?
Eldath and Sarath, and to help pick up Ajax.
Okay. All right, so you gather everybody up, and excuse me, start to make your way out of the town.
Because Sheldrick's idea is to save the people he can at least trust, to one degree or another.
Give me 1 second here. Okay, so y'all, you are able to so y'all want to head east. And you're able to make it out. Y'all gather everybody up, and the town's too preoccupied with either just the madness that has ensued from the ritual, or obviously the sight of big fella that showed up. So y'all make it out of town and get probably a good 30 minutes or hour away or so. Do y'all want to stop and take a short rest, or?
Probably a good idea.
Yeah, it sounds good to me.
I'm in.
Alright. You can go ahead and expend those hit dice and stuff if you want to.
Aren't you still asleep?
The sleep only lasted for, I think it was like 10-15 minutes or something like that.
Well, according to my sheet, I didn't lose any hit points. I was just unconscious, I guess.
And who was it that was mad? I know Ajax was. Owie, weren't you mad too?
I was something else.
You were affected with madness, you just weren't unconscious.
Yeah. I did do what other people told me to do.
Alright, so that's pretty much faded by now. And who, was there three of y'all or just the two?
It was Usul. He's disadvantaged, I think.
Okay, now he just has one level of madness.
What cures madness?
Greater Restoration.
Yeah, I don't have that.
And other spells of that sort. All right, so the Shashar says, you know, not too much further, and the boats will be up ahead, and there we should be able to set out across the lake and go where you want. And y'all suddenly hear a soft feminine voice sounds out in your mind, suddenly faint and distant. Hello, is someone there? Oh, please, I need your help. I've been trapped in the dark for so long. So very long. Please, please, won't you help to free me?
It's a trap.
And the voice, oddly enough, it, while it's in your mind, it appears to be coming from away from the shore.
I respond and say, I guess I whisper under my breath and say, "Can you hear me?" And wait for a response.
And you call out, but nothing answers.
Okay, I think, "Can you hear me?" And wait for a response.
And again, nothing answers.
Then I guess we can't help you.
I shrug and just don't care anymore.
Then the voice comes back into your head and says, "I need your help. I am trapped. Please, will you help free me?"
Where are you trapped at?
Sheldrick will scream out, "Where are you?"
You can tell that the voice appears to be coming off to away from the shore, not too terribly far away.
So when you say away from the shore, do you mean in the water?
No, not in the water, kind of like away from the shoreline.
So inland?
Yeah, inland.
I just kind of look around like I don't know what's going on. Like I'm dazed.
I look back at my companions and I point in the direction I think it's coming from and say, I don't know, do you guys want to check this out or do you want to keep moving forward?
I say we help.
Alright, I can get down on that.
Yeah, I agree to help, but what are we helping? I mean, I don't know what's going on.
It's a feminine voice that says it's been trapped here for so long, and we know the general direction it's coming from. That's all we know. And we're in the Underdark. Good enough for me.
So, I'll reply back loudly. Okay, I will help you.
I love that trait. So good.
Alright. So y'all trek inland and you suddenly... where'd my thing go? One second. You come to some doors in the side of what looks to be a tomb.
This never ends well in the books I've read.
Yeah, it's getting better all the time.
It's the Underdark. What do you expect?
Drizzt. Damn it.
We might need him.
You don't really notice anything out of the ordinary.
Do I notice any details or writing on the wall?
You notice that it is a deep-set door made of bronze encased stone, and has turned green with age.
Allie would like to knock on the door.
You knock on it and it creaks open, just a little bit.
I'm gonna fucking run away, I don't know, it's scary. I check for traps.
Alright, give me an investigation.
Alright.
Okay, yeah, you check for traps and don't find any.
I look back at my compatriots and say, will you guys follow me if I go in first?
Of course.
Alright, so I open the door a bit more, and
that was for a feeling of something bad going to happen.
Probably.
Alright, so you open the doors. I'll give you all a minute to get that resized. And
nope, I'm all good.
Oh, look, catacombs with blood drawings.
You see As you walk in, you see a stone, Dioroma, Diorama, stands to the right of the entrance, depicting the sorcerer Byrus.
Diorama,
yes.
Damn it, Chris, I'm gonna take away your speaking.
The sorcerer Brysis Keem of, as a Netherese noble in her prime, and she appears to be surrounded by attendants and slaves and other bits of wealth and power. And you see what looks to be floating cities. They cover the wall to your left.
What's with the staircase?
I don't know. You would have to find out.
That was a check to see if I knew anything about the paintings or anything.
No, nothing more than what I told you.
Well, maybe we should push on. I don't know.
I like it. I would like to stealthily make my way down the corridor to the end.
Alright, and you see stairs.
What's this thing right in front of me? What's this that I'm standing on now? Is it just like a bench or something?
It's just like another picture.
Okay.
One thing of note, as you look down there, it is completely black. There is no light whatsoever.
I've got dark vision.
No, it actually looks like everybody has dark vision.
Yeah, we did a good job.
The...
actually has devil sight, which gives him 120 feet, I think.
Yeah, Usul is the only one that can actually see down towards the landing. But barely. He is barely able to see that far.
Ugh. Ooh, do you see anything?
I'll move him around. What does he see, Chris?
You start to see the appearance of tapestries.
Anything depicted on the tapestries?
They're a little too far away for you to tell.
Alright, let's go. I will hold on to the wall and guide my way to the bottom of the steps with my battle buddies.
Alright, and as you come down into this area here, you see dusty tapestries kind of just, you know, scattered around the floor. And you see spots on the wall that have been defaced with deep gouges, making most of them unrecognizable. And you see an altar of pale gray marble that is gouged and cracked against a wall.
I don't even know how to respond to that.
Do an investigation check on those.
Alright, go ahead.
Yeah, I'll do that. Both Sheldrick and Usul will do that.
Alright, you get the feeling that this damage is relatively recent, and the creatures that caused all this damage left no tracks of any kind. And you can tell this because there is a thin layer of dust that covers the floor, and you see no kind of footprints, trails, or anything.
I look up.
Like disturbance, like something's been flying, they're like flapping wings or anything.
No, you don't really, you definitely don't see anything up. The ceilings are only 15 feet high. And while y'all take all that in, give me 1 second, I gotta go bring the groceries in.
Alrighty. Hey, Ajax, I don't suppose you prepared the light spell.
I only have one spell slot.
The cantrip, I mean.
Well, I think I did. I'm pretty sure I did, because I figured we were going to be in the Underdark.
Worst come to worst, I've got some candlesticks we can light.
Yeah, I've got light. So I can cast that on anything, I guess. Cast it on the tip of my spear as I punk it in some dude's eyeball. Create a real jack-o'-lantern.
Okay, I'm back.
Not very many groceries.
The kids grabbed most of them.
Good kids.
Alright, so you see... You've got a door in front of you and a door to the south. Oh, I'm sorry, you have a door to the east. I see south is actually to the left.
Do you guys want to go straight ahead? Because if we clear the north side, we can just do the south side of one foul swoop, probably.
That sounds good.
Yeah, that sounds fine with me. Or us.
Before touching the door, I would like to test it for look for traps.
You check it and don't find anything.
Do I hear anything on the other side of the door?
Nope, you don't hear anything either.
Is the door unlocked?
It actually is, yes.
I like to be polite and knock, but this is a scary place. I will open the door as quietly as possible.
Alright. So it's open.